Okay, guys, Ren Pavich, HVACR Tech. Hey, I'm going to put a disclaimer in here. What you're going to see in this video is not intended for homeowners or inexperienced service technicians. The repair that I'm going to attempt to do in order to provide temporary heating is being done by a person that has many, many years of experience, the tools, and the knowledge in order to do that. So if you don't possess that stuff, this could be considered very dangerous. Especially if you haven't thoroughly diagnosed the system prior to doing what I'm going to do. So once again, do not risk it. These things can explode on you. I've had them explode on me. It's not something I recommend. So if you're a homeowner, you may watch for some entertainment, but please don't attempt this. It's too dangerous. Okay, arrived at this location and it's 41 degrees out. It's going to be probably in the low 20s with the wind chill of probably like 15. We got to get this heat fixed. Okay, just got here. Space is 41 degrees. It's real cold out. This furnace is, it was kind of lockout. So first thing I'm going to do is just reset the power. See what happens here. See if we get lucky. Maybe it was a pressure switch got stuck or who knows. I don't know, should have lit by now. Nothing. Okay, let me troubleshoot this a little bit further, and we'll let you know what we find. See what we can see. Looks like my draft motor's running. Turn my gas valve open. Oh, that's probably the igniter. Let me check the igniter. Okay, might not be able to see it, but I ohmed out my igniter with my meter right there. It was reading open, which means it's bad. Okay, so my igniter was bad. I went out to my truck and I realized that at some point this morning I used my last one. I usually stock like six or seven universals, but I, you know, they got them on my shelf at the shop, and I haven't had a chance to go back there. It's 41 degrees in the space, and I got to get the heat on. I got to go through traffic, so round trip's probably going to take me an hour. The people just come back from out of town. I don't know what I'm going to do. People are real desperate. They need some heat. Let me think about this. I'll get back to you. Let me think about if there's something I could do. Okay, so at this point, What I'm going to do here, I don't recommend you do unless you're a trained service tech and you've done this or you've had somebody show you this. But I'm going to manually light this furnace and let it start heating up while I go across town and get that igniter. So let me see if I can do this. Once again, this isn't for homeowners. This is for technicians that are trained on equipment. Got it to light. Now, it doesn't have an igniter in there, but while I'm driving to go get that other one, I'm going to let this house heat up so they can get some relief. Now, once again, if you're a homeowner, you shouldn't be watching this. This is for trained HVAC professionals. Okay, I just got back and I installed the new igniter. Might be kind of hard to see. Let's see if it lights up. Keep my fingers crossed. Get this heat going. Woohoo! Got some heat! Oh, baby. Right on. Alright, so we got some heat. And in the meantime, by the time I came back, it rose like 6 or 7 degrees in the house, so customers can be happy. We got some heat. And once again, if you're a homeowner, you can't be watching this, because these are the tricks that we use as trained professionals. If you like my channel, like and subscribe. Thank you. Okay, all my little service techs out there. This wasn't a true emergency. This is my furnace in my shop. A lot of times you don't know what you don't know. Some of you may already know this, but if you're in a pinch and you got to get that heat on because you're worried about it freezing and you don't have the part right away, get you a candle heater and light that baby off. As soon as you hear that gas valve click, hit your lighter, let it light, and think about it. When the thermostat will satisfy, it'll shut off. So it's like a one-shot deal. Or if it goes off on high limit because something else is wrong with it, it's going to shut off. But if you're in a pinch and you got to get some heat in the building, you know, if you're up north here like we are, you got to kind of do what you do. You know, a lot of times it's not uncommon to go out in the country. Someone's got a problem. They came home after a weekend away, visiting family in the holidays. And they got no heat, and they're worried about their pipes freezing. So you light them up, you go to the supply house. Sometimes that could take an hour or two if you ain't got the exact part. You know, especially when it comes to, like, some OEM igniters that a universal won't fit in. You know, there's a lot of furnaces out there, and it seems like every time you go in the country, that's where they're at. So I didn't make this video for any homeowners. This is for trained professionals. You know, if you got any comments, leave them below. And thanks for watching.